Today, these ATV monsters probably one of the most effective quads in the world. You can pitch with this electric one. It looks not so cool as others, but you may be surprised with its performance. Stay with us, it will be interesting, let's go! Hi guys, as usual it's me, just a voiceover, and you're watching Review Machines. This video is going to be very unusual. Today we'll have a battle of the technologies. We managed to find so various and unique machines. The most capable and seriously modified quads will be compared with also very unusual machine, the insane custom electric ATV. We'll find out if electric machines are really becoming so effective not only on asphalt, but even on off-roading. But first of all, I want to thank ATV Club Northway for providing us these awesome quads. It would have been hardly possible to shoot this video without their help. And now I want to say a few words about their incredible machines. They are really worth of it. How do you like this blue beast? BRP Renegade XMR1000. Even without any modifications, it's quite an impressive quad, but this machine was seriously improved. Firstly, the standard engine with 1000cc capacity was modified with big bore kit, so the capacity was extended up to 1100cc. Then we see the double muffler RJWC that sounds awesome. As a result, the total power is 110 HP. The wheels with the Cincinnati Super ATV tires. The transmission was also improved. There is an intensified CVT and most other parts of suspension. The power body kit and both reducers were made to order in Canada. Also, there are numerous other modifications, I can't mention all of them. Just can tell you that the price of all this stuff is about $20,000. Of course, without the price of the quad itself. And another awesome quad, which is called Punisher, on the base of BRP Outlander. There are also a lot of improvements, modified CVT transmission, engine and exhaust system. By the way, this project was made by Canadian engineers from BRP factory. As to the wheels, here we see Gorilla Silverback tires, then RJWC mufflers, the music system soundbar bazooka, and many other things. Guys, we can speak about these quads for a long time. Each ATV here is an interesting, bright project. But as you can remember, there is another machine today, so let's move on and have a look at our electric demon. We've already made several reviews of some machines made by these guys. You may have seen them on the channel. It's electric transport tuning company EMAX. I think this company is one of the best in the world who makes the most interesting electric modifications. To compete with ATV monsters, they prepared the newest project. It's an electric quad on the base of Yamaha Raptor. Let's have a quick look at it. This Raptor used to be an unusual petrol vehicle that was turned into the electric beast with huge battery. It's a lithium 100 volts battery, 120 ampere hours capacity and 55 kilos weight. Then there is a proper electric motor, 35 kilowatts power and 22 kilos weight. As the result, we have an insane electric machine. It even was necessary to set a limit of maximum speed, up to 90 km per hour. The approximate range in regular conditions is 150 km. Well, on one hand, it's a rear-wheel drive quad, that is not good for off-roading. But on the other hand, it has lightweight and insane electric power. So I think it may have a chance to win the battle. Well, it's enough of theory, high time for the practice, let's get the machine started. And we start right from here. It's a rough field with quite deep snow that covers some holes and ditches. Let's go! Yamaha Grizzly starts, but immediately gets stuck in the snow. Red Outlander moves a little bit further, but then falls into a hidden ditch. The Punisher and the Blue Beast seem to be more effective here. They manage to cross this field, but anyway get stuck at the very end of this section. All the quads are extremely powerful, but weighty, so as we can see, it's very easy to get them stuck in a deep snow. Let's see at our electric ATV. Certainly it's quite hard for it to move here, but nevertheless it implacably cuts its way, slow and sure. Surprisingly, it can move on this field, where got stuck all the other ATV monsters. Maybe it's due to the light weight and high torque of electric drive, silent power such as it is, and the first point in favor of the electricity. Slightly shocked by the first results, ATV team is trying to get their quads out of the snow. But if it's really possible that so expensive monsters were defeated by the little electric rear-wheel drive ATV, with significantly less price. And speaking of the price, it's about $5,000 for the whole project. Well, this time let's try to accelerate on this flat snowy field covered with a hard crust. And again, almost all the heavy quads fall through the crust and get stuck. But our electric beast swiftly moves forward, right on the surface of the crust and not falling through it, due to the light weight. The only decent competitor is a Blue Renegade, that also can quite efficiently move here due to the extreme aggressive tires. Even here, on a slight ascent, but with deep snow, our little electric demon confidently rushes forward, at the same time when Renegade is far not so confident here. The ATV monsters have the last chance to score a point in this battle. It's the toughest of road we could find here. And in such conditions, big quads undoubtedly have a serious advantage. The matter is, we didn't have time to make the electric ATV waterproof, so it's dangerous to move in water right now. And this time Renegade is the only winner at this stage of our battle. Now let's enjoy these awesome moments of the new off-roading season. The winter is over, and soon there will be a lot of new reviews and tests of interesting all-terrain vehicles on this channel, so stay tuned, my friends! Meantime, Renegade gets out from this swamp with the help of the winch. The next one here is Punisher. Well, it seems to be not very successful try for the Punisher, and it gets stuck without any delay. After some time of trying to escape from this trap, it's getting clear. The only way is to tow back the Punisher by other quad. And again, it's time for our electric hero. Of course, it's much lighter than the Punisher, but we remember it has an insane electric power and torque. So maybe it's able to pull the heavy quad out of the swamp. Well, we were shocked, but it managed to do that. But how? So guys, you have seen everything, and I should say that all of us were shocked today by the results. Rear-wheel drive electric quad defeated all the incredibly expensive ATV monsters. Maybe it's the end of the era of gas engines, and it's time to get rid of them and move to the electric epoch. Well, I think it's time to say goodbye, guys. Thanks for watching, see you soon! Do you hear? It seems like something is burning. Well, I think it's high time to clear it up. Guys, did you notice the date of publishing this video? The 1st of April so soon, so we decided to prepare for you this video a little bit earlier. Let's see what we've had today in Rio.
Тут же Леша застревает. Я пока немножко еду. Олег, ты едешь за Ямахой, где-нибудь застреваешь. Потом я застреваю последний.
Certainly our little quad couldn't move in snow on its own. So we towed it by other quads. All the big quads yielded to electric one. But as a result, I think we have quite a funny video. And now it's really time to say goodbye, guys. Thanks for watching. Please consider subscribing the channel if you like this video. Stay with us, it will be many more interesting materials here. Goodbye.